Hello and welcome to another Bleistift video, and today I want to show you the Möbius and Ruppert 0970. It's a lead pointer and it's kind of, as far as I can tell, the last of its kind, in a sense that it's a lead pointer for clutch pencils without a blade, and that is adaptable for different diameters. Sharpeners like that were more common, or lead pointers like that were more common in the past, when lead pointers themselves were more used, you know, let's say by architects and so on, but they all use software now. You might have seen my Koh-i-Noor lead pointer video, that is a Koh-i-Noor lead pointer made in Italy from the past, looks very 70s. Yeah, that has a similar mechanism, you know, you can adjust it for different diameters. But the nice thing about the 970 here is it's still in production. Well, I assume demand is not that high, so I assume they'll produce a batch every now and then. And yeah, then they sell it off, then they produce a new batch. It works basically by grinding the lead against that wheel there. It comes with this cigarette filter like little foamy sponge thing to clean. Typical lead holder style, you have different holes here to extend the lead. So here you normally extend it a bit longer. So you basically make sure the lead is extended so that it will definitely completely touch the little grinding wheel on the inside. Or here, you know, if you use this hole, you can see the lead doesn't extend that much. So, and then you sharpen it, but the point is not super acute, you know, because once the point is too acute, it's easy to break. Also depending on what kind of lead you use. In my experience, for example, Koh-i-Noor leads, they break a bit easier. Okay, if you stick with one ecosystem, let's say, you know, with Staedtler, you get your leads from Staedtler, and you use your Staedtler sharpener, then of course that might be the best situation. But this sharpener will be made for this kind of diameter. Another advantage here, if you stick with the Staedtler ecosystem, you get a little cap that indicates what kind of lead you use. In this case, B is blue, and you can put that on here if you want, and then you know the blue one is B. Of course, then you lose the built-in sharpener. Well, Staedtler recently introduced this indicator for lead hardness, so you know, if you don't need it too obvious, if you just want to check what's inside without having to be able to grab a pen out of a pen holder, you can use this indicator. And I wrote let me just show it on here. I wrote an article about the guy who came up with the idea, Helmut Hufnagel, and how he came up with this idea, you know, what the background was. So if you want to read that, you're welcome to have a look. Okay, how did I find this sharpener? A while ago, let me check, when was it? 2017. I went to the Northern Quarter in Manchester, a very hipster place, and I found the shop called Deadstock there. That does the peasant alterations on liberal terms. Yeah, basically people bring their jeans there to be fixed and whatever, but he also has a little stationery section. And he did have the Geddes. I didn't buy one at the time. I came back a few months later, or was it a year later, I tried to buy one. He didn't have them anymore. He basically said they didn't sell well. So he sold them all to a friend for a good price. I was surprised. I mean, he has nice stuff here. Look, Kaweco. And I saw like little teenage boys going there and pestering their father to buy them an expensive Blackwing. So kudos to Blackwing for managing to market a pencil that is not that different to other pencils out there. I mean, I wrote articles about it. Ignore that now. Unless you're interested, then look for it. So basically, I couldn't find the Geddes. Then I looked into it, and then I was reminded that Lexicalica, here we are, had a nice article about the Geddes. They were invented in Switzerland. He has an old Swiss made one. And then basically he wrote about that the new version, now you grind the lead down here, and then the new version on this, let's call it a wheel. The new version is just metal with some sort of pulverized rough surface on, and it's not as long lasting. And in this article, he also talked about an alternative, which is we know which is his favorite sharpener, which is the M&R 970. Problem is, even though I guess he was able to buy it in Germany, they are not really available in the UK. I contacted Möbius and Ruppert. They told me ask the distributor for the UK, which is a company called Global Art Supplies. There was a big confusion because, you know, because there's a different lead pointer from M&R, so they first mixed them up. But in the end, luckily, it started in 2019, it finished in 2020. In the end, luckily, they managed to get me one. It was about 10 quid, which I think is a good price, and now I finally got it. So, yeah. If you stick to one ecosystem, let's say if you go Staedtler all the way, then probably not much point. But if you have different lead holders, there's a Cut and Dash, Rotring, Kaweco, and so on. If you have different ones, then you have different diameters. This diameter will not fit. And actually, when I used the Kohinoor in this sharpener, I had lots of lead breaking. And hopefully these adapters are an answer to this problem. Because we have different adapters for different diameters. Okay, let's have a look. So the blue one here, for example. Well, where do I measure though? I guess you would measure at this end. So the blue one, for example, here is a bit more than 1 centimeter. Oops, the yellow one. Yeah, 9 millimeter. The orange one. 8.5, and the green one, let's get it off. Eight, yeah, so we have eight, this was 8.5, wasn't it? 8.5. 9, a bit more than 9, and 10. So hopefully, one of the bigger diameters, like here, the Kaweco brass, flat to flat, it's 10 millimeters, 1 centimeter. Let's hope something like that could be used. So let's try it. We want a good point, right? Yeah, let's just do it a bit longer. Okay. Might not work with the Kaweco. Because still not big enough. Basically, I would only... I couldn't hold the pen still, so the pen would rotate, which means... Yeah, I would only always get the same side. So we kind of need to rotate the pen. Let's tie the carandash. Yeah. That works well. I can probably even go with one of the smaller sizes. Guess it's for people to figure out which one they want to use. Let's see whether I can use the Kaweco without any adapter. Would that work? Yeah, that would work. So, yeah, this is a good solution. We've got a sharpener like this, without a blade, where I grind down the lead nicely, and I can use it for different diameters. Obviously, if you change pens with different diameters a lot, you'd have an issue because you'd always have to replace the adapter. I guess in a case like that, you probably prefer one of the more traditional sharpeners. This one is great, you know, you can close it, you can open it. But it has a blade. So if you want to just sharpen quickly, that might be a good solution, nice and portable. But if you want something more rotary-like on your desk, if you don't switch grip diameters too often, this is a very nice lead pointer. And as far as I know, the last rotary style lead pointer still in production with different adapters. And price wise, you pay a similar price as for the Staedtler. The only problem is difficult to get, so I hope maybe if there's enough demand, maybe some stores like Cult Pens in the UK or Jet Pens in the USA will start selling this nice sharpener. At the moment, difficult to get. Okay, thank you very much for watching, and until next time, goodbye.